and very happy to be here virtually. And I'm very grateful and honored to be given the Annual Freedom Award from the International Federation of Liberal Youth. I would, however, like to say that while I'm a more visible face to the civic hacking movement in the past few decades, it is a collaborative work of hundreds of thousands of people who donate their talents, their time, their resources on furthering not only the freedom of software, of the freedom to use, freedom to look at, freedom to copy, freedom to change, freedom to apply, but also people who have worked on the freedom of assembly, freedom of speech that underlies the whole free software movement. In particular, I would like to thank the late civic hacker Aaron Swartz, the internet's own child, for pioneering many of not only in code but also in writing of the radical transparency that I'm currently practicing in Taiwan. I would also like to say that today at the Open Government Partnership Summit in Paris, while I was delivering the closing keynote to the subnational sessions, I said the government, of course, wants to regain trust, especially from the young people who, for many of us, are no longer putting the trust in the democratic institutions unless we get to build it ourselves. However, we can only expect people to trust the government if the government trusts the civil society and the private sector in the first place. If the government is willing to put as much trust to the general public, to the collective intelligence, it is then in a position to expect some of or equal trust in return. And to give no trust is to get no trust. And in this era of people generally, you know, caught in filter bubbles and caught in their like own small circle of friends, it is foremost importance to me, and I hope to you also, to cultivate a culture of listening. What I mean by this is not only in form, like in a online forum or in an offline face-to-face meeting, but that we deliberately set up some way to translate whatever we have, the materials, to people who don't have equal access to information, for people who prefer a more graphic, more interactive, or more tangible way of accessing the same information. And only when it's made accessible can people enter into fruitful deliberations. And again, the deliberations must be facilitated by people who are neutral, who do not have a stake among the stakeholders, and to fully record and transcribe the consensus points during each and every meetings. And this is so that we can collaboratively build using the spirit of the open source free software, free culture movement, a new kind of governance model that responds to people's expectations, that lets people take care of each other's feelings. If we're trying to reinvent democracy by reusing the same top-down models as imagined by the paper era, then what we will build is a new institution that's perhaps more participatory, but no more transparent, no more accountable than the governance structures that preceded us. So again, I thank you for the award, and I really hope that we can collaborate more on the scalable listening and on getting the listening quality into the policymaking, both at a national and subnational and local and just day-to-day life level. Thank you so much.